Hello friends, you're welcome once again to another mathematics edition made possible by the Novell Learning Support Studio. Today, we will be considering a topic in mathematics that has to do with geometrical construction. Geometrical construction. This is our first lesson of week 4 and the third term of SS1. Now, I'd like you to get a mathematical set handy. Now, please get yourself a mathematical set handy. Now, in your mathematical set, you find your set square. Alright? You find your set square. Okay? You find your protractor. And you find your compass and a divider and a ruler. Let us come handy with a ruler, a compass, alright, and a pencil, because you're not expected to use the pencil that you're using for construction to make, you know, lines and draw lines and stuff like that. So get an extra pencil. I hope you have fixed your pencil on your compass. If you have, let me tell us that today's lesson is intended that at the end you should be able to construct a bisector of a line. You're also going to learn how to bisect a given angle. We'll learn how to construct a perpendicular bisector, after which you are required to learn how to construct special angles such as angle 60, angle 45 degrees, angle 90 degrees, angle 120 degrees, angle 135 degrees, and so on and so forth. Now, I hope you have your ruler handy and you have your compass. Okay, let's go to the class. Now, as stated in our objective, you are expected to learn how to construct a line, how to bisect a line segment. How to bisect a line segment. Now, permit me that I will not be writing out various steps as a matter of fact because of time, but I'll be demonstrating, and I hope you have your paper handy so you just follow through and do exactly what I am doing. All right, we want to construct, we want to bisect a given line segment. All right, now let's say I draw a line. All right, and I want to bisect this line and take any radius at all, any radius that is, you open your, let me demonstrate that, that is, you open your compass to a given radius. As soon as you do that, all right, you lock your compass up. Now, let's say I've already taken my radius. And I do something like this. I hope you can see that. I replace this and do something like this. Okay, having done that, let me place this compass here and perhaps reduce my radius or take another radius, okay? And let me do something like this. Something like this. Okay. Haven't done that, you take away your compass, place it at the other point, all right, and take something like this, then go down and do the same thing, all right, let me take my compass off, and let's try to join that line together. Okay? What you have done, you have succeeded in constructing a bisector of a given line. All right? Now, remember that after drawing that line, we actually took a radius. Let me call this point B. All right? We took a radius. And then I placed my compass and had to do what I did. You understand? When this is done, you have actually succeeded in constructing a bisector of a line segment. Let's see how we construct a bisector of a given angle. Now, let's take a line. And I want to assume an angle. Okay. Now, at the point of origin, this is O. Let's say that this is this line here represents OA, and this line represents what? OB. And we want to bisect this angle here. Please grab your compass, place it at the point of origin here. When that is done, take a radius that is convenient, all right, and bisect the line AOB and OA. Now, when that is done, remove your compass, go to the point where you have A, line OA, where the stroke cuts line OA, and take a stroke, all right? Then go to the point where the arc cuts OB, all right? And take a stroke. When that is done, let us join this point that is created. Okay, we join it back to the origin. All right, now we have succeeded in constructing a bisector of an angle. So we can call this point C. Let's call it C. That is the point where this angle is what? Divided. This particular angle here has been divided into two equal parts. All right? So you know how to construct a bisector of a given angle. All right? Given the angle, we created an arc by bisecting line OB and OA. Then I said, you take a radius. After you take that radius, please create a stroke or an arc and then return back to this line and take another arc. After doing that, we join the points here to the origin where we started from. And hence, we have bisected this particular angle. All right, now having done that, let us see, how do you construct a perpendicular bisector? How do you construct a perpendicular bisector? We'll do that right away. Let us call this line AB, all right? Let's call the line AB. And then you grab your compass. Take any radius that is convenient for you, all right? Okay, I want to place this compass here. I want to take a convenient radius, all right, and do that.